This is the YGTV News with Georgina White.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Monday the 5th of December. I'm Georgina White. An unfortunate event in Turnbull's Lane occurred Sunday evening. The GSLP rallied on Saturday. Fabian Picardo wants National Day back in casemates. The GST held an open day in John McIntosh Square on Saturday morning. Local singer Giles Ramirez releases his first solo album today. Three of Gibraltar's rhythmic gymnastics teams win at the British National Group Championships. And finally, over 2 million worth of scrap metal when supercars pile up in Japan. A tragic incident occurred on Sunday afternoon at around 4 p.m. It is reported that a 63-year-old woman took her own life at her home in Turnbull's Lane. The RGP has reported that the woman was a UK national and they are investigating the circumstances surrounding her death. Saturday afternoon saw the GSLP Liberal Alliance hold an extremely successful rally in casemates. With a bouncy castle, face painting and mini sports for the children, the adults were kept entertained by an empowered speech delivered by Fabian Picardo. He discussed the party's wish to bring back National Day to Casemate Square, ending his speech with a famous National Day balloon release. YGTV spoke to Mr. Picardo about the event.
Fabian, tell us a little bit about today, what's been going on and how you feel it's gone today.
This has been a massively well-attended rally in Casemates, the home of National Day, where we're going to bring National Day back to on the 10th of September. It's a fantastic culmination of campaign event. We've got a couple of more days of hustings to go. But what we're celebrating here is not winning a general election. We can't celebrate that until the 9th of December if people decide to deposit their trust in us. We take nothing for granted. We have to fight for every vote. But we've been fighting for every vote, very cleanly, explaining our policies, setting out what we believe Gibraltar should be doing for the next 4 years, and we've been celebrating that. One of the unfortunate things to talk about in this rally has been the fact that supporters of other political parties, I think I can guess which, have been removing our manifestos from people's letterboxes, and people are saying to us, look, everybody else in my block has got it, but two or three of us have had it removed from our letterbox. It's a great pity. I'd like to think it's children who don't know what they're doing rather than our political opponents.
The Gibraltar Social Democrats held an open day in John McIntosh Square on Saturday afternoon. Candidates walked around greeting people and answering questions whilst a band played in the background. YGTV spoke to leader Peter Caruana to see how the event and the campaign was going.
Well, we're absolutely delighted with the response from the general public to the GST. We've existed as a party for nearly 25 years. We have had more support than ever to our public meetings. We had 750 people in the John McIntosh Hall. You know, the GSD appeals to the silent majority. We appeal to the people who think quietly, make up their voting decisions quietly, and then go and vote for what they believe is the best option for Gibraltar. So our support comes from a wider section of the population than that which is willing to come out and party in the middle of the day.
Giles Ramirez, a local musician, has released his first solo album, Ultimate, today. The album covers a compilation of old and new songs. Some of the pieces on the record have never even been heard before. The CD will be released officially this evening at his launch party. We caught up with Mr. Ramirez and asked him how it felt to release the album and what inspired him.
Well, you know, it's a first in as far as solo projects go. You know, I've released many, many albums with both local and international bands, but this was a first for me in as far as a solo project thing, so I feel really, really, really happy about it. You know, I mean, everything has gone into place like fantastically. Brilliant musicians playing on it. I think the songs are, I mean, obviously I'm going to be biased, but I think the songs, they each have a very unique message in their own right. And the quality of the sound is absolutely fantastic, so I'm really, really happy about it. Like, different angles of inspiration on the album. I mean, I get inspired by mostly anything, you know. I mean, walking down the street, I might see something which catches the eye, and I'm going to write something about that. The media, the press, everything, photographs, movies, anything will inspire me at a given moment in time, you know. So I draw inspiration from anything that's happening in the world, you know, whether at this moment in time or in the past.
Three of Gibraltar's rhythmic gymnastics groups competed in the British National Group Championships recently in Cardiff. The first group named the Rubies competed for the first time and managed to place 12th overall. The second group took third place for the freehand and first place for the ball routine. We talked to Sally Holmes, head coach of the group, about the team's experience at the competition.
I think it was fantastic. I think it was really good for Great Britain to see what Gibraltar brings to the competition. I think they now realise that Gibraltar is a force to be reckoned with. The team that we actually beat, the Bath team, they've been undefeated for the last 3 years. So for us to come in at our first competition and beat them was wonderful.
And finally, a luxury car pileup occurred on the motorway in Japan yesterday. 8 Ferraris, 3 Mercedes, a Lamborghini and 2 Toyotas crashed into each other. The car leading the group of supercar enthusiasts tried to change lanes but crashed into a barrier, causing the accident. No one was seriously injured, but the damage is estimated at over £2 million. That's the YGTV News. I'm back tomorrow evening. See you then.